Here we are, where everybody wants to be right now.
This is what table tennis is all about.
There it is, he does it! Look at this, the fans, seventh heaven right now. And he takes it.
They are.
Chengdu is the city to be right now if you are a table tennis fan, and that's because it is the host city of the 2022 ITTF World Team Table Tennis Championships Finals in what has been a tremendous past week or so here at the Chengdu High Tech Sports Center. And we're now into the last 2 days, which means we will have a grand final at the end of today. But first up before that, we have two fantastic matches in the men's teams semi-finals. First up in just a couple of minutes, it's Korea Republic against Germany. Following that, it is China versus Japan. And those two teams will be in action again for the women's teams finals at 7:30 p.m. local time. Our intentions, though, first of all, are with this semi-final, Korea Republic versus Germany in the men's teams event. And with me here is table tennis aficionado and commentator Fraser Riley. Fraser, so good to have you back with us. What about this one? What about the matchups here?
Fantastic to be alongside you, Shahzad, and here at Chengdu for this prestigious event. And I'm expecting a very tight match here between Korea Republic and Germany. It's a repeat semi-final from Halmstad. So can Korea this time topple Deutschland? I mean, they've got the strongest team I've seen them have in a very long while, Korea.
You also have been telling me about the mental strength of this Korea Republic side that maybe is right up there with the Chinese.
They've had so many players that have been able to challenge and even beat the Chinese in the past, such as Jung Yong Sik, Lee Sang Soo, and a couple of these men as well have beaten a few Chinese. So let's see here if they can beat a new German team. We're missing a three Olympic silver medalists, Timo Boll, Dmitry Ovcharov, and of course Patrick Francisco.
So these are the results so far for Team Korea Republic. The only time they've dropped a match was against Egypt, perhaps a little bit of a surprise there, and Hong Kong, China in the quarterfinals. Otherwise, Canada, Czech Republic, Egypt, and Saudi Arabia, all very, very straightforward.
Interesting to now see An Jae-hyun, who was the player that lost to Shady Manji of Egypt, now play against Germany. He is a world championship bronze medalist in 2019, the breakthrough star of the year.
Yeah, big expectations. Coming through, we have Team Germany there, who have beaten Kazakhstan, lost to India, beat France and Uzbekistan, and Croatia round of 16, and then France. They've dropped a few matches along the way, haven't they, Fraser?
They have, and I think it's quite a new team. We've got the recent Grand European champion, Sean Dan, spearheading the German side. Benedict Duda, the dude, as Adam likes to call him there at number two, and we have Kai Stumper, who seems to be the best young player in Germany. I mean, says something if Jörg Roskopf selecting him here. And he was the young man who began to twist the tide for Germany in their rematch against France in the quarterfinals. What a comeback that was from the Germans.
Yeah, you had a feeling that France would go through in that, so that's a fantastic result. So don't forget the two semi-finals today, Korea Republic against Germany, China up against Japan. At stake is a place in the 2022 World Team Championships Finals. So a lot to play for here. And you feel that this is going to be a long, hard affair today, don't you?
I'd be very surprised to see a 3-0. If I'm to put my head on the chopping block, I think that Korea are favourites and that they will win this match despite Germany's second seeding position. I think this Korean team is sublime. So let's see what happens here in this semi-final.
Yep, the first matchup, Jung Woo-jin up against Benedict Duda.
The left-handed tall German up against the speedy, electric-footed Korean. It's going to be a great match. Jung Woo-jin will be looking to take it. He's been in exceptional form, Jung Woo-jin, this season. He's won a couple of WTT events. He's beaten Chinese players such as Zhang Peng, the youth world champion. He's beaten Liang Yaning, the new man on the scene for China, who I reckon could be playing some of these team events in future if he carries on the way he is. And this German here, Benedikt Dudar, whose rise has been steady and slow, but he's beaten some of the world's best himself. I mean, he beat Felix Lebrun in the deciding match yesterday against France 3-0.
Nothing to be scoffed at. That's a massive achievement, isn't it?
It's a big achievement. He's beaten players like Tomokazu Harimoto previously. And of course, if you're one of these teams, you're quite happy that you're not on the side of China in terms of the draw.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. Japan have certainly drawn the short straw on that one. Just inspecting each other's bats here. We have a couple minutes now before the warm-up, before we get things underway. We'll also now tell you a little bit more about these players. Jung Woo-jin, 27 years of age. He's 17th in the world as well, Jung Woo-jin. 9 years a pro, and we mentioned earlier, he's also got a world championship medal, doubles. Last year he got silver and two bronzes in the team event in 2016 and 2018. He's also got a silver in the World Cup in 2019 and the Asian Games silver medalist for the team event. Benedikt Dudar is 28 years of age, the left-hander. He's 36th in the world, so ranked far below his opponent in that sense. And he's been a pro for 10 years. He's also been with Germany before in the men's team event, the Summer Olympics. He got a silver medal and helped them get a couple of golds as well in the European Championships over the last couple of editions. They've met once before. It was a very long time ago at the World Junior Table Tennis Championships, which Benedikt Dudar won 3-2. His highest ranking has been 30th in the world. Jung Woo-jin has reached 9th. He's been a top 10 player. And yeah, you can just tell that is the quality of this man. Xie Ying is the umpire for this one. Just looking at the results of these two. Benedikt Dudar opened up with a win against Kazakhstan, 3-1. Kirill Gerasimenko. And then he followed that up with a win, a loss, I should say, against Satyan Nanasekaran, 3-2. But that's always going to be a tough one. Alexis Lebrun lost the first match, 3-0. Before beating Abdulaziz Anarbayev again, of Uzbekistan.
Sadly, okay. Clutch came back 2-0 twice against Dudar and Chodang, instrumental in India's win in that group stage. Benedikt Dudar has been on the receiving end of two losses after being 2-0 up, which made his victory against Felix Lebrun even sweeter against France.
Yeah, he lost against Alexis and then beat Felix. Cross point the board for Jung Woo-jin, who started with a very easy win against Canada, Wang Cheshuan, and then Jan Valenta of Czech Republic, all in straight matches. Youssef Abdulaziz of Egypt. Mohamed Elbaid 3-2, a little bit tougher against Egypt there. Against Poland's Miłosz Rojimski, he won in three straight games. And then Ng Pak Nam of Hong Kong, he won 3-0. Chin Tin defeated 3-1. So he's had a pretty good tournament so far. Hasn't dropped a match yet. And he started really well here.
Hasn't dropped a point yet. You can see in the first point he was pinning the middle of Dudar. He's a taller player. It's a good tactic against tall players. Really hard to deny Jung Woo-jin his forehand. He can play it from wide backhand. He runs around playing forehands for fun. And for quite a shorter player, it's amazing. Very surprising how good he is away from the table at fishing, lobbing. Amazing in the loop-to-loop game.
You're suggesting with the taller, bigger players that you drop it short as much as possible.
You can drop it short. Of course, your touch has to be of good quality. A bit easier for them to come into the table, the taller players, but harder for them to then make the adjustment to come out. And that's why playing into their middle, their crossover section, is a really good tactic. Fujin, letting the ball drop. He was away from the table, spinning at the back of it. Produced a lot of arc on this forehand here. Look at that. Skids off the table.
Point lead, he maintains that, Jung Woo Jin.
Net 5-2.
Volley! Volley!
Volley! Volley!
Volley! Volley! Volley! Volley! Volley! Starting to make his move. Happy with that shot, will he, John, would you?
No, perhaps he could have made a touch. I mean, he went for a very risky Chiquita flick. Came almost under it there. It's kind of bouncy, so maybe he could have come over the top of it a little bit more.
Started with a lot of pushes. Quite a rally that one was.
Jusek Yuk there, the Korean coach. Finalist at the 2003 World Championships. Defensive legend. It's interesting to see a defender coaching.
That's a coach, right?
A team of attackers, yeah.
Yes, Clay!
Off the serve. Excellent work from Jung Woo Jin.
Good out for a tall player. Doesn't want to be receiving too close to the table. Can get surprised. Quite a long, fast serve such as that. Great timing there from Jung Woo Jin.
Looking fairly comfortable here, Jung Woo Jin. Went for it, Jung Woo Jin.
Judo doesn't need to feel too much pressure in this first game because at the end of the day, An Jae-hyun against Cho Dang up next, and I'd say that the German Penholder is favourite in that encounter, so Duda doesn't need to feel like this is a must win in this opener, and unlike some of the other teams we've seen where their number one or number two really has to win the first match.
Right, that puts an undue pressure on them, doesn't it?
Mm.
Yeah, slightly different feel here, but Sonny wants to get as good a start as he can, Duda. From Duda, who's now just 1 point from his opponent.
Racket speed was amazing there. That was against the slow Chiquita, and he just came through it so quickly. It didn't really matter what spin Jung Woo Jin put on it. Just dismissed it down the line, as you say. That was beautiful.
That's not taking for Jung Woo Jin. Benedict Duda is level. He's beaten the likes of Tomokazu Harimoto, Matthias Falk, Simon Gozzi, Christian Carlsen in the past, Koki Niwa, Truls Morgard as well, earlier this year.
Impressive list of wins Duda has. You could argue that he's slightly underranked at 36, but I've seen him in quite a few matches being in great positions and can't finish it off. And you can't be a top 30 level player if you don't have that killer instinct to match points.
That's a great backhand, isn't it? Cross court for Benedict Duda.
very fluid and against a decent push of Zhang Ruijin. It wasn't very heavy with backspin though, and it wasn't too deep on the table. Could have been a bit better there from the Korean number one.
He's just in front here, Duda. And he's now got game points here, Benedict Duda.
This is massive here for him. Takes less time to win in terms of score, scoreboard position in the best of five format in teams than it does in best of seven, of course, but swings and roundabouts, right? It takes less time to come back as well.
Yeah.
As Wang Xiuqin illustrated yesterday against Carlsen.
Yeah, what an epic match that one was. This time he doesn't miss Zhang Ruijin. He had to get that right. Saves one game point.
It wouldn't surprise me to see him take the next point as well on serve. Duda's froze there on the touch. Didn't read the top spin. Thinking about the outcome too much and he knows it.
Right, let's see how Zhang does on the serve. Second one.
Net. 9 point.
Will he go for the same serve again after the net court? It's always interesting to see that.
Whether they'll take the gamble. How good was that forehand?
What a set piece that is. Masterclass from Mr. Electric Feet. See Roy Sung-min, the Korean legend in the VIP box next to us. Sure he was happy with that one.
We are at deuce here. We need a winner by two clear points now. Jin has turned this around. He's now got game point.
Duda played a very good point. I mean, look at this. Who else can play balls out of the middle like Zhang Ruijin, apart from the very, very best Chinese players? Duda perhaps should have made a bigger risk and maybe gone down the line to the wide forehand.
That would have been risky, but you have to take these high-risk shots, right?
Definitely. Don't want to get into the rally with Zhang Ruijin.
Zhang Ruijin takes the first game after facing two game points. So it's that second game now. Zhang Ruijin was pushed all the way there, Fraser. Was that a little bit of a surprise for you? Or did you kind of expect that to happen?
We've seen it in a lot of matches. The first game is the closest. The guys are just becoming accustomed to it from the start, right? And they feel the pressure from the get-go. But then they ease in and start valuing every point and treating it on its own merit rather than thinking about the stage, the centre stage that they're at.
And they haven't played each other for 10 years.
Dana, come out!
So much redundant, isn't
it? Exactly.
Wouldn't surprise me now to see him all one-sided game. Zhang Ruijin isn't the kind of player that will keep, that will take his foot off the pedal if he's in the driving seat.
One, two.
A little bit of acknowledgement there from Benedict Duda. We love to see.
The way he stepped in there in that final ball, came into the table, opened his racket face. He's having fun now, Jang Woojin. He's not afraid to go back and lob and get into the loop-to-loop games. Look at this. It bent outwards after he made contact. That was spellbinding play.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant from him down the line. Down the middle.
It's so smooth. Yeah, almost sporadic with the footwork, the way he moves around the court. Scuttles about the place. That forehand has to be top five in the game right now. Despite his 17th position on the world ranking, I think he's even underranked at that position.
You feel that's not a true reflection of where he should be?
I think he's top 10 right now, definitely.
So that's a lovely backhand, isn't it? Cross court from Benedict Duda.
Well, that's a risky take if you're Jang Woojin. It's an expensive forehand and he's paid the price. Nice block from Benedict Duda. Keeps the bat high. Racket angle closed. Nothing Jang Woojin, even with his footwork, could do to reach that. From the German. Bostock delighted with that. Slow spin, got a passive ball, and comes over the top. Made a nice adjustment there. And Jai Hyun now has begun to warm up in the training hall.
To go for that corner, Benedict Duda. Done on the serve, and that's the most vocal we've heard from the Jun Pi.
Korea haven't made a final since 2008. Germany have made the finals in 2010, 12, 14, and 18.
That's a big opportunity for the Koreans. And he's just starting to pull away. Duda now is in a little bit of trouble here. Going 2-0 down, I think, is going to be a tough, tough ask.
Missed a few of those Chiquitas, Jang Woojin. Playing it from the forehand side, it's a very high-risk shot.
Jang Woojin has a win percentage of 67, 132 wins and 196 matches coming into this tournament. He's actually done pretty well against left-handers, 65%. He's won 42 of 65 matches against lefties. Benedict Duda. His win percentage is very close as well, 66%. He's won 177 matches out of 270.
Got it!
This is a good run, and he's done this again, similar to what he did in the first game. Duda is right back in it.
That's a delicious receive there. I feel like it almost has to be placed that well to stop Jang Woojin from playing that forehand of his. Takes good composure when you're trailing as well to realise that slow spin is going to be effective.
Seven.
Duda has gone in front.
Call those a chorring. I feel like saying chole, but you also raise your hand and say sorry. You'll still take it.
Sorry, I like it.
another point here from the German. But he blew two game points in the first game.
Yeah.
And look who has the serves.
Yeah, that was clutch, wasn't it? Those serves. Now, three game points. Better than he had in the previous game. Benedict Duda. In a good position here. Only one serve left here for Jung Woo-jin.
Got it!
Duda converts. You'll feel a lot happy about that. One all now. From Benedict Duda. He takes that second game against Jung Woo-jin, 11-7.
Wenn du bei deinem Ausschlag, er hat eine gute Platzierung, ja? Wenn er mal komplett
So we're all square here in this US team semi-final. Team Germany up against Team Korea Republic. One all going into the third. Benedict Duda to serve.
Well, I definitely favour the route one play and direct discipline of Cho Dang over the flair of An Jae-hyun. So if Duda can swing this Germany's way and take this first one 1-0, this, honestly, Germany would probably win this then.
Volley!
Saying that if it goes to four, Jung Woo-jin will play Cho Dang, and that's pretty much 50-50.
Well, this is a toss-up at the moment, depending on what happens in this first match. So crucial.
Sometimes if you have history, it almost creates the mutual respect and it can actually make the match closer because you feel the tension more.
Got it!
Oh, from Duda. And unlike the previous two games, he has the better start in the third one.
Perhaps Jung Woo-jin is going to want to try and get in with the backhands in the third balls a little bit more often now, because if he's stepping around to play the forehand, Duda then might be able to play those kind of shots. It's going to stretch him against his momentum.
3-1.
We'll see if Jung Woo-jin realizes that.
You give a big thumbs up there. Why was that? Tell us.
He span up with the backhand side, which means that he's neutral to the table. He can play the forehand if it's played there. If he plays the forehand from the wide backhand side, Duda's going to block him cross-court. I'll play a forehand down the line to the open space. So Jung Woo-jin there realising that getting in with the backhand in third ball is very good.
Take it ahead from the Korean.
He's missed a few of those Chiquita flicks from the middle to forehand area. I can't believe it.
These are things he probably does spectacularly in training. He needs to apply it here now in the match scenario. Two down front by two. Rally again.
He did the hard bit. He got Jung Woo Jin away from the table.
That's what he wants to do, right?
Couldn't put the cherry on top. Dropped the bat a little bit too much to create the spin. He could have drove it instead.
Another long rally. This time it's Tudo comes out on top.
Very good container of the ball, Benedict Duda. Very consistent and stable. Good posture when he plays. Head stays still, stays low. Very taxing on the body, especially as a tall player. Wow.
Now, a 3-point lead. Good position here now. The last two games, it's been the other way round. And Duda fought back. Can Jung Woo Jin do the same here?
He hasn't found himself in his position yet here in Chengdu, Jung Woo Jin. He's going to have to dig the deepest he has because he's been buried at the moment. Not dead, though.
Yeah, in a difficult situation here. That's about as big a lead as Duda's had in this match.
He's tense, Jung Woo Jin, he's nervous. Slower recovery there. You can see his concern on his face.
Went for the long serve.
8-4.
That's better.
I can imagine now Jung Woo Jin will play the reverse pendulum serve a little bit more. Perhaps short into the backhand of Duda with a bit of side spin. So if Duda pushes it or touches it, it'll sit up to Jung Woo Jin's forehand, which is what he wants. That's Jung Woo Jin's bread and butter. I haven't seen so much variation of the serve in Jung Woo Jin, which is unusual.
You think he's kept it a little too simple with the serve?
I think so. Do you remember that long, fast surprise one in game one that he hasn't really played that since?
Duda is looking good here, isn't he?
Oh, Duda day. No, but on a serious note, though, his touch play is very, very good. He's denying Jung Woo Jin that forehand, and it's frustrating the Korean.
Well, Jung Woo Jin has a lot of work to do here.
Man, oh man, that's a good flick.
He is coming back here slowly but surely. Played a few of those already, hasn't he?
Into the middle once more.
9-7.
I'm out. Yeah.
You can see why the Germans have done that. Just coming back into the picture here, Jung Woo Jin.
The timeout from Moscow. Jung Woo Jin is sneaking through with those tippy-tappy toes. Closing door. He's going to have the serves now, Benedict Duda.
Time out
there. Former world doubles champion in the corner who has been a coached since I can actually remember. Richard Prowser, another instrumental man for the German development.
Seine langen Ausschläge in allem Spiegelreden, die er gemacht hat bisher. Ja? Sei bereit für die. Aber jetzt Fokus auf deinen Aufschlag. Dann, ja? Gute Platzierung. Nach außen die Platzierung machen soll. Ja? Okay? Auf geht's. Komm, komm, komm. Schau.
Yeah, crucial juncture of this match now. Zhang Wujin was on a bit of a roll for that timeout. Yeah. That was right. Three game points here to go 2-1 up, Benedict Duda.
Half long backspin serve. Very, very effective there. Causes some indecisiveness.
We couldn't convert that one, and it's Duda and Germany in a decent position here now in this first match. So Benedict Duda takes game three, 11-7. 2-1 up.
Ja, deinen Aufschlag machen, ja, der Unterschied zwischen dir
und du. 지금 저 진짜 돌리고 하나. 근데 야, 그만, 이런 식으로 해봐. 어? 야, 너 체력상 한 것 같아, 체력상. 중요, 지금. 하나씩 해봐, 하나씩. 편하게 해봐, 편하게. 커브도 길게도 좀 섞어주고, 이쪽 저쪽 다시 넣어주고. 똑같이 하면 제가 너무 좋아하는 것 같아. 초반부터 초반. 체력 모아봐, 체력, 체력. 모아 힘.
is now crucial for Zhang Wujin to stay in this match. He has to win this game. And actually, you've got full confidence that he could do that. Zhang Wujin, Fraser?
I just think it's some of the matches that I've seen in Duda. He has the intensity to go 2-0 up or put himself in a brilliant position, but he struggles to finish it off, especially against players who he knows he's not expected to beat. It's almost like he begins to think about the rankings a little bit.
Now listen, someone like Zhang Wujin has beaten Zhang Jike, who was world number four at the time. And that is no mean feat. That's his biggest scalp, Zhang Wujin.
Table tennis. For all the people who think table tennis isn't a sport, tell them to tune in right now, because how could you argue it's not? Look at this like anatomical contortion here. The amount that these players need to stretch to prevent themselves from tearing a muscle on one of these shots is incredible.
Tennis! Oh,
table tennis is a sport.
You'd be surprised she's out. As well as Zhang Jike, he's also beating Xu Xin and Lin Goyuan. Jung Woo Jin. He's one of the biggest threats.
Yes, come on!
Yes, come on, you heard that. And that's three top Chinese players. Incredible. How many players can actually say that?
Well, Liam Pitchford's beaten Ma Long and Xu Xin. Harimoto has beaten Lin Goyuan, Ma Long, and Fan Shendong. Ball has beaten Ma Long. Zhang Jiqiu, I believe, once. I don't think he ever beat Xu Xin on the international scene, sumo ball. And Zisk has beaten Xu Xin. He's beaten Lin Goyuan and Fan Shendong. And Ma Long, actually, Francisco, he's beaten those. Beat Ma Long recently at the Summer Series, Francisco. Almost forgot about that. Don't know how.
This one's tight at the moment, this fourth game that Zhang Woojin would need to win to give Korea a good start. Has drawn level.
Again, he misses that backhand flick from the forehand side. That's been
quite a few.
So he's serving half long into the forehand or touching half long. And Zhang Woojin would rather play the backhand flick. Maybe that says something about his confidence in his forehand touch, Zhang Woojin, right now.
What a response that one was from Duda. He's playing with confidence.
Time out.
Pushes along, braces for impact. Wow.
It's now the Koreans who have asked for a timeout here. Fraser was just telling me during that interval that he has every confidence that Zhang Woojin is going to turn this around, not only with this game, but to win the first match. What's prompting that, Fraser?
He loves the contest. He loves to dig deep, and it seems like sometimes Benedict Dudar isn't able to thrive in the same way in the tight moments. I don't always fancy it in the fourth or fifth game, Dudar.
Got it!
Really wrong in the decider against Felix Lebrun. Could he about be doing it here? Look at this. And that flick out wide off the serve. Zhang Woojin. Maybe needs to stand a little bit more neutrally.
Yeah, really good placement there from Duda.
Got it!
Prediction is running away from you, my friend.
I should have said it.
Here's the Korean women's team looking on. They've had a disappointing campaign.
Surely!
Wow, he's playing really, really perfectly tactics wise, Benedict Duda. German engineering coming through.
Yeah, precision all the way there from Benedict Duda. And now, Zhang Woojin. He has to dig as deep as Duda did a little bit earlier on in this match.
Four, nine.
Problems here. There's also the unforced errors today for Jungle Jin. There's been quite a few of them.
He's got a high-risk game, right? Percentages haven't been there for him.
Net. 4-9.
Seems to be being rushed.
9.
He's got a lot more to do here. Jungle Jin.
No timeout left for Dudar in case Jungle Jin begins to create some momentum here.
That's better. That's much better for the Korean.
Made that look like taking candy off a baby.
It was so easy, wasn't it?
Made to look so anyway. Look at this. Oh. Might have some scar effect, that shot.
Now let's see if we can build on this.
Got it!
Dudar's got match points. Look what that means for the German camp.
Too loose, and Ricardo Walther shaking his head for a second as well, saying, I can't believe my teammates about to pull off this win.
High toss. Oh, easily put it. Lovely.
Bit of flair there from the Korean. Is it too little too late though?
You would assume so, but he's still got another serve. And they have taken the first match here. Jungwoo Jin has been outplayed by Benedict Duda. I think Fraser was talking about Jungwoo Jin's next match. Is that what you were referring to?
Well,
not going to be this one.
That is an incredible performance, one of the best victories of Duda's career, and it couldn't be on a bigger stage. Roscoe and co are absolutely delighted. He managed to put the game there of Jungwoo Jin, and now Cho Dang looking to play An Jae-hyun. This could be 2-0 to the Germans in a matter of time.
Really good start for the Germans, perhaps an unexpected one. And Jungwoo Jin has lost to Benedict Duda. The German has won 10-12, 11-7, 11-7, 11-7. And now we're going to hear from the winner. Here is Benedict Duda.
Congratulations. Firstly, please tell us about this match.
Thank you very much. It was a tough match against Jungwoo Jin. He's a very strong player. And I know I have to play very well today to win this match. And I'm happy.
How important is it in a team format to win the first match and take the lead?
It's very important, yeah. It's just a little break, but it's just 1-0 now. We have to keep going now for Team Germany, and yeah, it's just the beginning, not the end.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Humble but wise words from Benedict Duda, and he's called it right. The start's so important. But it now sets it up for Cho Dung, for Team Germany to continue that momentum and see if he can increase that lead against Team Korea Republic's An Jae-hyun. Stay tuned, more action coming up.
Keep it on my body, I'm broke if you ask it. Don't gotta sell it, most of y'all is flawless. Broken whistles, long as it is foreign. Heard you want it, cause the yams enormous. What's in, since she isn't gorgeous. Live my life, last name a Morgan Freeman. Trying to touch a forest, do not know we're knocking on the door. It's came in, I came in, I came in. Did it like the Porsches, humming in. Yeah, flex, I just wanna win. Yeah, LA BB, who we running with? Yeah, 2-2-3-3, I'm on 10 again. Okay, all right. Coming in, yeah, flex, I just wanna win, yeah, LA BB, who we running with, yeah, 2-2-3-3, I'm on 10-10-10, yeah.
We are into match two here of the World Team Championships semi-finals between Team Germany and Team Korea Republic. Team Germany, perhaps surprisingly, have taken the lead here. Fraser Riley with me. He's still pretty much amazement at what Benedict Udo has achieved here.
Yes, Shahzad. Well, I mean, usually a bonus comes after something good, right? Yeah. It's come straight away. And it's Duda that's beaten Jang Woo-jin, Korea's number one. And to be honest, this was the most set in stone win that I expected. Jang Woo-jin beating Duda, but it hasn't happened. He's had one of the best wins of his career there. To see how well Jang Woo-jin's been playing at the moment, taking titles with foot. And now Cho Dan going in as the favourite against bronze medalist from the 2019 World Championships, An Jae-hyun, who we know is amazingly talented with some of the best feeling in the game, but he can become a little bit passive, An Jae-hyun, at times. Cho Dan is the furthest thing from passive. The German penholder and recently crowned European champion. Germany, right here, could be taking a 2-0 lead. It's going to take an upset here. Jang Woo-jin beating Cho Dan to give Korea a chance and a foot in this semi-final.
Well, this is quite the turnaround at the start of this match. No one expected that, really. And it is. Let's give Germany a great platform now.
And then the Duda's men's doubles partner, Cho Dan, taking stage.
An Jae-hyun. 47th in the world. An Jae-hyun, and he's had a decent tournament, started with a straight games win against Canada, and then Czech Republic, Tomáš Kukla, pulled us shot. He won 3-1. His only other match, he lost to Shadi Mukti of Egypt. He has played since. Cho Dan is 25. And he's also now in the top 10 in the world. 11 years a pro. Started with a straight games win against Kazakhstan, and then India to beat Amit Desai, and then lost to Satya Nanasekaran. They've never met before, these two. Cho Dan at his current highest ranking, An Jae-hyun. He has reached number 35 in the world. Cho Dan. Felix Lebrun, 3-1. Then beat Alexis Lebrun, 3-0. Against Uzbekistan, he won in three straight games. And then against Croatia, he won again in three straight games. And the quarterfinals, they met France again. They lost. He lost to Felix Lebrun, 3-1. And then beat Alexis Lebrun. So he's had a bit of a mixed bag, but he's the main star, isn't he, of this German side, Cho Dan.
Definitely.
Of Chinese origin, born in Germany, and his parents, who were table tennis players, moved across.
An Jae-hyun is almost preposterously relaxed, the way he plays. The feeling is unfathomable at times. Hold the table, he goes back, he lobs, he fishes, he chops, mixes it up a lot, and Jae-hyun. Cho Dan's in this first meeting, he's going to have his wits about him, because he varies things a lot, and Jae-hyun.
France medalist at World Championships in 2019.
Unseeded, he had to qualify through the groups, it was just completely unexpected.
How rare is that for that to happen? And the reigning European champion as well, Cho Dan. So, yeah, we've got two top quality players here.
Won it on home soil, beating Darko Jorgic quite convincingly, actually, in the final, Cho Dan. He's had a very quick rise himself. It's impressive as well because he's been able to sort of retain that kind of ranking that he's achieved, coming up into the top 10 for the first time in his career recently, winning the contender Lima.
So, highest ranked pen holder in world table tennis, showdown. That's quite an impressive achievement because there's not that so many of them around these days, right?
Exactly. Some people say it's a dying art, but Turodang Wang Chunting and Felix Lebrun would argue otherwise.
Oh, what a return that was. Keep this alive and turn it around here. It's still going.
Oh, my goodness.
What a point that was. Andrzej Hin, he's won that.
You see the feeling there? Came in off the drop shots. Caresses it on the side spin he was producing there. The first ball that he did. Hooked around the side of it.
Well, that has been the point of the day so far. It's safe to say?
Definitely, definitely.
Got it, got
it. It's all good and well producing points like that, though, but, yeah. You know.
You've got to do the other stuff, right?
Yeah. Got to do the basics well. Some players like to use feeling straight away, almost trying to set that up. Some just use it in the case of an emergency, and it's tough to tell sometimes which of those Andrzej Hin is doing.
Really impressive, but like you say, Clark had a run of himself. Let's go down, let's bounce back quickly.
It's quite hard to keep your focus against an RPB reverse parallel backhand, as you say, Shahzad, there's not a lot of them, so.
Tell us a bit more about the RPB, the reverse Penhold backhand.
So it's a modern style. It was invented by Liu Guoliang as a way to prevent the Penhold style from becoming extinct.
And that's because backhand is generally seen as the susceptible side of Penholders, right?
That's right. You'd use the same side in the traditional Penhold style to play the backhand. You'd use both sides on both the backhand and the forehand of the racket. Roy Sung-min of Korea was the last ever Olympic champion to use that style, and there's not many, if at all, players using that, right? That's only Lee Shan-yang and the women's doing it, but there you see it in full flow of the RPB.
Yeah, have a look at this. This is the RPB in action. It looks awkward, it looks difficult, doesn't it, the RPB?
Because you have the three fingers on the back of the side that can get in the way sometimes.
Really well.
Yeah. The advantage of this grip that Turodang is using is that the racket's automatically a little bit more close, so it favours the forehand and it gives you a bit more freedom with the wrist as well, so it can be really good with the serve. We've seen a lot of strong Penhold players being amazing servers, such as Xu Xin and many others. The umpire didn't tell them to get on with things because that was a wild long pause.
Yeah. It did take some time.
Is it again? You might see one in there, but he almost drew out that moment there.
Do you think that was deliberate?
Perhaps to make that long serve even more surprising.
Some of these shots today have been unbelievable.
If there is such a thing as talent, Andrzej Hin has it in absolute bucket loads. Chu Se-hyuk would have been proud of that chop. And look at that. That ball was barely long.
I just wonder whether he's had an influence in some of this. When they play those defensive shots.
It's different because a lot of the Koreans are kind of in your face with the way they play. Everything's off the bounce. Andrzej Hin's different. He's got like European flair, but also the ability to counter topspin like the Koreans. So it's...
That's a nice mix for you.
Definitely easy on the eye.
Well, it's working now. 2-point lead here, Ahn Jae-hyun. Brilliant. Well, we've seen the contrast, haven't we, in those 2 points from Ahn Jae-hyun.
The flair and the ferociousness. Look at that, an absolute whirlwind.
Ahn Jae-hyun wraps up that first game, and he's done it in some style as well along the way. So a good start for the Koreans here in game two. They had a good start in game one as match one as well, but Ahn Jae-hyun has won this 11-7. Talk about Ahn Jae-hyun. He's beaten the likes of his own compatriot, Jang Woo-jin, Tomokazu Harimoto, Wang Chun-tin, Emmanuel Leveson, Matthias Falk. He seems to really enjoy the big moment, doesn't he?
I can't even remember him taking an international tour title on the WTT scene, right? But on the big tournaments, when there's lights, camera, and action, he raises his game and really showcases himself. I mean, I've seen him against Rere Sipos in the WTT European Summer Series. The feeder, as strong as a feeder as that was with those kind of players, he didn't seem to really care at all. He's going back and loving it, 10-9 down in the seventh. Which, you know, just it's like he didn't care what happened. But in these tournaments, the Worlds especially, he really showcases himself.
Well, he's doing the business at the moment, but see if he can continue it.
1-2.
High toss serve here. Didn't work out for him. Showdown just in front.
I see Ahn Jae-hyun is the kind of Troels Morgaard of Asia. Runner-up like Troels Morgaard, but it was Matthias Falk that beat him in Budapest in the semi-final stage in the deciding game. Ahn Jae-hyun interestingly beat his teammate Jang Woo-jin in the quarter-final, also in the seventh.
There was ever a time to highlight the point we've made by my fellow commentator here. This is it. Look at this.
He takes it so late and he comes around and almost underneath the ball, and it's got a deadening effect, and that's why Cho Dang's block goes into the net.
Excellent point to Ahn Jae-hyun.
Ebbing, flowing, and showing. And we're going to see another Cho up next. Cho Sun-min up against Kai's jumper.
I mean, I know that one. Cho, you're a massive fan of as well.
Well, there's two Chos. There's Cho Sun-min and Cho Dae-sung, and they're both left-handed phenomenons. I would favour Cho Sun-min to beat Kai Stumpy in the third match of this tie.
Come on.
Allez, hop.
So much flair from Chodan, a very attacking player at all opportunities. A lot of the Germans are like that, apart from Timo Boll, really, who showcases hand switch shots and whatnot a bit different in that sense. European champion, 1 point in the lead right now with the serve.
Oh, he lost his footing there, but he was lucky. 4-6. Chodong that it never made it. He's just hurt his knee, I think, perhaps.
Oh, I hope he's okay. He's just stretching it out. Doesn't look too concerned, but that could have been nasty. I've seen that a few times.
Yeah, his right foot gave way, didn't it?
Slips. Is he all right? This might not be good. Seriously, might not be good for Germany here.
He's still, I wonder how freely he's going to move.
He's limping, oh no.
He is limping.
This could be disastrous for Team Germany with their number one being injured. He's going to receive maybe an injury timeout now.
Now, it could be just a matter of some spray or something. He doesn't look too bothered at the side, is he? But he isn't walking comfortably, is he?
No, well, the physio's arrived. He looks a little bit like Sabina Winter from the German team. I actually thought that was her yesterday, but it's not.
They've got up to 10 minutes, haven't they, to sort him out.
It's hard to tell from that angle, really, what happened, but you would have thought maybe he could twist his ankle. He looked more interested at that point in what was happening on the table than what was happening with his foot.
It was only after.
Right. It's the kind of thing where if a player doesn't stretch, they could really, really hurt themselves there.
Now, let's assume he can carry on for a second here, Fraser. He's going to be okay. We hope he will. There we go. Now, An Jae-hyun, he's going to try and take advantage of this, isn't he? He's going to try and maneuver his opponent around a bit more.
Well, we've seen injuries affect the other player sometimes. World Championship in 2015, Ding Ning rolled her ankle over in the deciding game and still won that World Championship. Finally, affected Lu Xiwen's mentality. Let's see if it affects An Jae-hyun's. Doesn't have seemed to. I mean, we say the saying, kicking a man when he's down, but this is too big of an occasion here to show any respect to the opponent. On the table, that is, of course.
2 points in a row. He's walking from a pretty freely at the moment. Show that. So that's a plus.
Yeah. For a second, like he was limping, but if he can feel even the slightest twinge, that can have a huge impact mentally.
Yeah. Yeah, we just gonna see how these next few points go now.
Great!
It helps. That certainly helps. Doesn't it?
Grace An Jae-hyun was that it was actually shallow on the table. If that was deep and high, that would have been put away pretty easily by Chodang, you would have thought.
High toss, perhaps.
Chodang stepped in too early on the flip. An Jae-hyun might have spotted that in the corner of his eye.
You think he anticipated it, he preempted it?
I think he's the kind of guy, An Jae-hyun, that does a lot of things that the watcher won't notice. massive moment here in the second game. To not see a high toss serve again from Andrzej.
I thought he might go for that. And he went for
it. Chodan kept his foot on the gas there. And into forehand and then down the line.
The high toss has served him well so far.
Literally served him well.
Yeah, I'm just surprised.
Yeah.
Well,
Chodan is in front here. Delighted now. Andrzej here knows this is a pivotal moment. He wins this game. He goes two up here.
Chodan can feel a twinge in his muscles, though. He probably won't want this to go the distance.
Yeah. Exactly. Well, good set up, game point here.
Chodan's backhand is just beautiful. And look at this rotation. Transfer from the right leg to the left. Very, very explosive.
Hi.
Game points he saved. Now, do you think he's going on to win this?
No. You've got to stop putting me in this position.
You don't want to commit to that, do you, now? Well, he will very gladly take that on Jacob, but that's going to be a bit frustrating for Chodan.
I just hope Chodan couldn't hear your laugh in the commentary box, because he wouldn't have appreciated that.
It was more out of
just surprise, really.
Surprise.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
Andrzej
Huyen has turned this round a bit similar to what Jungwoo Jin did in the very first game. And he'll be relieved.
That's a massive moment there in game two. And now he's one away from levelling things, and that would really, really make this semi-final clash interesting. As I say, I favour Cho Sun-min to show his way to victory against Kai Stumper in the third match of the tie. If he can wrap this up here and now, Andrzej Huyen, I would favour the Koreans to progress. That would absolutely neutralise the upset of Doodah beating Jungwoo Jin first.
Andrzej Huyen has taken that second game.
12-10. It's 2-0. Yeah, let's see what we can do. It's a second match. It's a normal match. I don't think it's a normal match. It's a normal match.
3 best players are not in this squad. And for this Germany to get to the semi-finals is something impressive, isn't it?
Mm. Shows the strength in depth. Like Oschenhausen, Dusseldorf, Starbuck, and they have a lot of centres.
The best league in Europe, isn't it?
Generally. I would say so now, yes. Yeah, definitely.
One, two.
Really impressed me here on Jai Kim. It's been a topsy-turvy in terms of upsets and what's going on in semi-final so far.
I mean, a lot of these players have defied those rankings, haven't they?
Absolutely. Impressed there with Cho Lang's backhand down the line. The energy that he created forward into it was brilliant, but that net card, I mean, it's just more insult to injury.
Yeah. Well, we'll just be keeping an eye on Cho Lang and his movement, and he seems to be okay there. Not too many problems with mobility, thankfully. Look at that from Cho Lang. It looked like it was Andrew Hu's point.
Can't hit a forearm better than that if you're Andrew Hu. Leave the door open though, wow. I love those kind of points with those blocks. Oh, yeah. To the open table, it's just so satisfying to watch. And Jai Hyun's going to want to vary that receive a little bit. I think that Cho Lang has a better backhand down the line than An Jai Hyun does.
Ooh. Wonderful on the backhand there from Cho Lang.
Seeing more nets than a curtain shop right now.
I mean, how frustrating does that get for the players?
It tends to level itself out, so you've got to brush it off.
Good run of points here for Cho Lang. The lead is three. Misses.
His ability to keep the ball in play on Jai Hyun is very good. Can make you quite impatient against him.
3-point lead. Cho Lang enjoys at the moment.
That quality received there. He holds the wrist back, brings it forward quite wide out of the comfort zone of the RPB. Some people would have been surprised to see An Jai Hyun selected over Cho Dae Song, but that's obviously something that Choo Se-hyuk think favours the Koreans stylistically. And he'd be right so far looking at this match, Choo Se-hyuk.
Restores that 3-point lead, Cho Lang. Ah. this rally between these two.
He's staying in points and you feel like he has no right to win, Anjaik. And it's like he embraces the challenge more when it's tougher. But look at that, he misses the easy one coming in.
Big wry smile from Anjaik. He's enjoying himself out there. So he is now staring at a 4-point lead, and Joe Dung needs just two more to make it 2-1. Well, this is a late rally here from An Jae Hyun to try and
you can really hear that behind that flick, couldn't you? It's still quite a lot of body that goes into a flick.
4 game points. So, Joe Dung has halved that lead. And he's pulled one back here. Very important for Joe Dung to stay in this, of course, otherwise it would have been 1-1 in the tie. So, Joe Dung has won game 3 in 6. It's now 2-1 in match 2.
Genau, das meine ich ja. Für diesen, wenn du den ersten Ball spielst, er blockt nur. Lass dir für den nächsten Ball Zeit. Du hast unglaublich viel Zeit. Er blockt den Ball, der ist hoch, der ist letztens zu spielen dann. Aber lass dir für den Ball Zeit und spiel dann noch wieder nächsten. Ja? Du gespielt jetzt. Ja? Ja? Er muss das Niveau halten.
Ich dachte, ich habe eine Banane. Ich habe auch lange Quatsch.
Und wenn du die Banane hast, die wieder nur schnell die Banane reinspielen. Das ist so weit gut. Der Schubball ist da. Ja?
Ich spiele bei 8, 8 und 9 Uhr nicht mehr rüber.
Immer wieder die Banane aufbauen.
So we're going into game 4 here now with Cho Dung very much back in this.
Okay.
That slight injury timeout we had is a thing of the past, I'm sure. Let's hope that he's okay. Jae Hyun played some sublime shots earlier. Wonder whether that one takes it now. Let's move towards Cho Dung.
Element of nerves being 2-0 up, and then your opponent takes the fourth, especially in a best of 5.
There's the RPB in full flow. Carrying over that momentum, isn't he, from the previous game?
Both are so strong at the touch of play. That is a very hard shot to play with the RPB, that Chiquita.
Yeah, that looks so hard. Very awkward.
Three,
wonderful stuff here from An Jae Hyun. That's why his teammates are on their feet.
Clever there from the Korean. Sizeboom flick. Throw down steps and then he exposes the right forehand. Showdown basically is going to have to come up with something a little bit better than that. He's either going to have to switch down the line or he's going to have to turn the corner and fool Ahn Jae-kyun with the forehand in terms of placement. It's the Korean footwork again, the way they just skim around the court. It's mental. It's seriously mental how they do that. So quick.
Well, you'd imagine this is a German timeout.
Time out.
It is indeed.
Charles Morgan, isn't it? The entertainment value you get.
I mean, this is a vital game here, and he's trying to pull out stuff like that.
Three punch knockout there. Uppercut around the side of the jaw, and then he just knocks it out.
It off. But you know, I mean, Ant's kind of put him in that position.
It kind of fed the combination. There wasn't enough, was there? If you're going to block like that with that kind of intensity, which wasn't massively intense, you at least need to move the opponent around. One wide, one into the middle, something like that.
Three in a row for Cho Dan. Amused by the situation, Ahn Jae-kyun. Flustered.
Might live to regret going back and lobbing like he was.
I was just thinking that was a catalyst for this little run here. And you just wonder, did he need to do all that?
Some players care about the way they win the points. In terms of entertainment value, the French definitely stand out for me in that regard.
You like that French flair?
It's good on the eye. It's not the most effective against, especially the Asian all-out aggressive players. Absolutely butchered top block. If he's going to play the feeling, he needs to be more in situations like that. That's still putting pressure on Cho Dan and not giving him a massive amount of time.
Shows you how much backspin was on that ball, though, that he managed to generate off a topspin. You can only really chop back against a slower spinny ball, though.
Jolly!
He's back in France. He's happy about that one, isn't he?
This would be An Jae-hyun's second best ever career win after Tomokazu Harumoto, who he beat in 2019.
That would be something. Just a little closer to that time.
Recently crowned European champion in the way he's playing, winning contenders. Yes, I did. And he's still there.
He's still there. You're right.
Timeout from Juicy Hyuk. This is a paramount point in this match.
It is.
Timeout. 계속 긴장하고 있으니까 편하게 하고. 짧게 짧게 흘러 나가는 것도 잡긴 잡아. 그러니까 너무 막 편하게는 안 해도 돼. 더 확실히 짧게 주던지, 짧게 하고 그 타이밍에 그냥 너가 좋은 쪽으로 확 주던지, 뭐 아니면 뭐 치키타 간다든지 뭐 이렇게 나가. 지금 이제 서비스 이제 길게 또 이제 짧게 넣으면 어떻게 할 거야?
To call this a hugely important juncture of this match, off the tie, really. I'm astounded by some of the shots that this guy played by Jae-hyun.
The way he can turn defense into attack is just mind-blowing. Massively surprising as well, isn't it?
Love that counter. Now, match points here. Superb. At times, truly brilliant. Other times, he confounds. But most importantly, he has taken this second match.
And you can see a smile on the face there of the Korean number one, Jang Woo-jin, because that guarantees he will have another shot to redeem his performance in the opener. And he would play Cho Dang in the fourth. Let's not forget about that.
Yeah, that could be the match to watch. But look at this. He has entertained us, hasn't he, today, Han Jae-hyun. That is superb. And the Koreans know how important that was. So, a good win here for An Jae-hyun. He defeats Cho Dang 11-7, 12-10, 6-11, 11-8. He wins by 3-1. It is now 1-1. between Team Germany and Team Korea Republic. Let's hear from the winner, An Jae-hyun.
Congratulations. 恭喜取得比赛的胜利.
감사합니다. 축하드립니다.
감사합니다.
How did you keep your cool to level this tie?
네, 첫 번째 질문입니다. 어떻게 평정심을 유지하시고 이기셨는지 궁금합니다.
일단은 경기를 일단 16강, 8강도는 안 치르고 4강부터 처음에 치렀는데 솔직히 처음에 좀 긴장을 좀 됐는데 이제 일본에서 우진이 형도 이제 이길 것 같았는데 좀 경기를 어떻게 지게 돼가지고 이번에서 꼭 이기지 않으면은 좀 팀이 좀 불리해질 것 같아서 좀 더 집중이 됐던 것 같아요.
He said, I didn't play too much on the round of 16 and the round of 8, and I'm very, very nervous, but I believe I must win this match. Chu Seongmin is playing next. What are your thoughts?
네, 다음 주자는 조승민 선수님이신데요. 어떤 기대를 가지고 있는지 궁금합니다.
승민 형이 그냥 하던 대로만 하면 이제 3번 경기에서 무조건 이길 거라고 생각하고 있습니다.
He said, I believe he will win the game. Thank you.
Thank you.
감사합니다.
감사합니다.
Well, if that is An Jae-hyun nervous, I would hate to see how he plays when he's confident, because he certainly plays some very, very assured shots there. But anyway, that has set up the third match beautifully. It's Cho Seung-min versus Kai Stamper. Stay with us.
Can't escape when you call my name. When you call my name.
The city of Chengdu with its plains there on the one side and then plenty of buildings on the other. This is the Jin River that courses its way through this beautiful city that has a certain laid-back style about it. They pride themselves on it, and it has a population of 21 million people. It's all happening here at the Hi-Tech Sports Center in this men's semi-final between Korea Republic and Germany. It is one all. It is beautifully poised for match three. That's coming up very shortly indeed. And we've been treated to some excellent table tennis so far, haven't we, Fraser?
What have we ever done, Shehzad, to deserve table tennis like this? But yeah, both the opening games there, the match one and two, they've gone the opposite way to what you would expect. But of course, that's kind of neutralized out now.
Yeah, I mean, forget the predictions anymore, because they just haven't gone that way yet. We're into match three with Cho Seung-min and Kai Stumper.
This side. 2 minutes.
Cho Seung-min has won the toss. Cho Seung-min, 24-year-old, the left-hander, 65th, who's had a pretty decent tournament so far. Against Canada, he won 3-1. 3-0 against Czech Republic. And won his match against Mohamed El Bayali of Egypt, 3-1. And then Abdulaziz Bung Shalaibi of Saudi Arabia, 3-2. Was pushed a bit there. Kai Stumper, 19-year-old, the right-hander, 103 in the world. He's only been a pro for a couple of years. He's not played perhaps as much as some of the others. Beat Emmanuel Lebesson though, 3-2. That's a great result. And then one against Uzbekistan. First meeting between these two. Cho Sung-min has been as high as 40th in the world. Kai Schumper, 69th. Just finishing off Kai Schumper's results. And he beat Tomislav Mucar of Croatia, 3-1. And then against France in that quarterfinals, beat Jules Roland, 3-1. Results for him. He's the lowest ranked of the entire German squad, and yet they've gone with him today.
First game. It's to do with how well he's playing in the Bundesliga, beating quite a few top 30 world players in the league. Can he do it here against a top 30 level player in Cho Sung-min? Had a good season so far, Cho Sung-min.
Cho Sung-min beat. Chicky in round 16, but lost to Wong Chun-ting in the quarterfinals. 3-2. What do you like about both of these players? Cho Sung-min first.
Uzer's class, very fluid. Again, the high toss serves, quick over the table. Nice backhand out of position, they can play as well. Smooth player, Cho Sung-min. Schumper, who's quite jagged, short and sharp in the way that he plays, in all senses really.
And you said he might be preferred because he plays a lot closer to the table.
Right, that's why I think he's been selected over Ricardo Walter.
Got it!
Although Walter is very, very talented player with amazing touch. Not as effective that against the Koreans, who will punish you if you give them too much time.
One, four.
I fancy Cho Sung-min in this match, especially watching him at the feeder back in August, which he won beating Haro Yoshimura.
Well, look, to be fair, as you say, both matches have kind of confounded expectations, including yours.
I bet Korea would win this, so as long as that happens, you can keep Shoshi.
Still
going for Korea. Yeah.
Do you think John Woodson can redeem himself in that? In that fourth.
I think he can, although it'll be interesting against Cho Dang.
Yeah. Well, it's a good lead here for Cho Sung-min. 6-1. Biggest lead we've had. He really needed to get that point to peg back Cho.
Germany are here right now in the semi-finals because we came back against France and it was Kai Stumper that began that comeback.
That's a good point actually, because they looked down now, didn't they, against France?
Interesting that it came from their youngest player and least experienced player, that comeback.
It's a good point you made. In fact, he actually went down to Jules Roland in the first game, and it probably looked, okay, here we go, that's it, we're going to lose by three, but then he turned it around spectacularly. And I think you felt earlier in this tournament that it would be France marching on their way to the final against China.
Probably should have been against Germany, right?
5-8.
Although the LeBruns, I think, as good as they are and as fast as they're progressing, would have struggled against this Korean team.
Yeah! 5-5.
Chris Schmidt was starting to have Kai Stumper put the pressure on, but he's relieved that somewhat.
9-5.
He's now got 5 game points here, Cho Sung-min.
not many players like Cho Sung-min in the Bundesliga. I will say that.
Cho Sung-min.
Six. Ten.
Has to wait a little longer.
Seven, six,
game two, so Cho Sung-min, I think that's one of the bigger wins we've had so far today. Cho Sung-min, he looked comfortable pretty much from start to finish, didn't he?
Yeah, I was never really in doubt that. I'd expect to see a stronger Kaish jumper come firing out of the blocks here in game two. Tangoing with the neck quite a lot actually in this game, but
did.
Wouldn't have made a difference either way. Cho Sung-min deserved that first game.
He did, and he takes it 11-6, goes one up here in match three.
Okay. Ja, er spielt ja langen Rückgang, er spielt ja halblangen Rückgang.
Japan are going to be playing later on against China in the other semi-final. They have their work cut out for them, but they just started their warm-ups. So Fraser, what does Kaish jumper need to sort of do or work on in this second game for you?
It's tough to say. Stylistically, this doesn't really suit him too much, to be quite frank. To receive tight. Cho Sung-min knows that Jumper has a strong backhand flick, so he's going to probably serve quite wide to the forehand to remove the German's ability to play that stroke. He's doing it to the middle and the forehand there. Not comfortable to flick that as a right-hander. He's going to have to play the parallels a lot as well, and Cho Sung-min's very good in the rally as well, so Kaish Jumper's going to have to on his very top game.
Yes, the youngest player in this just the lowest ranked of the players here in this tie.
I don't know if he truly believes he can win this, Kaish Jumper.
Yeah, I was just wondering whether that self-belief is... There's been a doubt there, perhaps.
He would have lost to Dojuland. That would have been a bad loss for him, actually. But this is a different level of test.
Go!
Of 69, he's won 89 of 129 matches. A decent record. Kaish Jumper is at 55%, 11 out of 20.
Joe!
And actually, interestingly enough, I told you he's got a win percentage of 55, but he's got a very good record against left-handers.
Right-handers are quite few and far between compared to right-handers.
Sure.
He may not have played like the
It's
the
not
top.
Many. I mean, he's only played four matches. He's won 3 out of 4, but still.
Yeah.
You'll need those sort of statistics. And he's in front here. He's up by 4.
Eight, three.
Game of serves right now. The under-19 champion of Europe last year. Doing very well here. Dominant in Europe, but we see a lot of players who have been dominant in Europe then not been able to dominate the world, right?
Well, he's dominating this game, that's for sure. He's turned it around really well here. Stumper. Becker from Cho. They have more to do though.
Wow. Yeah, that shot looked like it was nothing there, the German.
6 game points, Kai Stumper. High toss serve. He has done really well here, Kai Stumper. Double quick time, he wins that second game. Perhaps for Korea. So submit as Kai Stumper has beaten him 11-4 in game 2.
It's interesting, Shazad, because you don't think of Kai Stumper as a high toss server, but he was giving Cho some mini taste of his own medicine with that respect. It's working well too. And he's keen to get on with things. He's rushing his opponent. Quality in his serve and second ball have been very, very good, and they have to be, because the longer the rally goes on, the more I fancy Cho Sung-min. But if he can really put pressure on him from the get-go and the serve receive, he's got a chance here, Stumper.
This is finely balanced at the moment. Both of them had good wins in their respective games.
Jumper's backhand, it's not in the flick department, but in the open rally, is quite slow and spinny.
Power there for Cho.
Paid the price there for not having enough quality with that long push, Jumper. It looked a little bit hesitant, a bit half-hearted. That was an element of nerves, I think. Did well there, put it away nicely. Forehand chop, watch his jumper, but it was just so high. Cho Sung-min still knew how to give it an element of wrist and spin into that shot because there was a bit of backspin on it. Good composure from the Korean.
Yep, in a much better position now than he was in that last game. High toss there. He's far more comfortable now. It's incredible because these games have, each game has been fairly one-sided.
The changes that both players have made, the other hasn't been able to adapt to.
Excellent from Cho.
Couldn't ask for a better name as a table tennis player, Cho, could you?
Exactly. So appropriate. Improved, isn't it, from Kai Stumper?
There's an English player called Tintin Ho, and her brother's actually called Ping Ho, so I think that's up there.
That's up there, I agree. away with this third game. Cho Sung-min really has followed the pattern of one player dominating the other, alternating. We've been here 2 hours now in this tie. Disappointment for Cho Sung-min.
Nice jumper. I mean, such a young player still. Obviously, Roscoe believes that he could be a future heavyweight, but it's quite predictable where he goes with his placement jumper. Like anyone at this level, if he has enough time, he'll have too much power for anyone to really deal with, but you have to create your own time by being unpredictable and good in the touch play. He's got a unique serve motion. The recovery on that chosen min forehand is just second to none.
6 game points for Cho Sung-min. One saved. Match still back, but is that just delaying the inevitable here? Cho Sung-min looking good in this third game. So well done, Cho Sung-min.
It's an absolute lightning bolt.
Look at this.
Wow.
Anticipated that brilliantly.
I love it. Absolutely love it.
So, Cho Sung-min.
너도 힘들고 저도 힘들지만 쉽게 가면 안 된다니까. 너가 같이 너도 힘들지. 빨리 그래서 같이 가야 제대로 흔들려 준다고. 그거 하나 하고 지금 마지막에 저 백쪽으로 일자 넣었는데 제가 치키타 했지. 이제 깎고는 제가 돌리냐 못 돌리냐. 그러면 그런 것도 한번 해봐. 초반에만 조금만.
Jang Woo-jin looking to redeem his performance. He will play Cho Dang next. His partner and coach there just replicating a few things which Cho Dang may be looking to do, and that's why players even mid-match, mid-team match, will go into the training hall just before they play. Cho Sung-min right now, for the first time in a fair bit, giving his team an overall winning position. 2-1 up here, drawn 1-1 in terms of the tie. This third is a huge moment. Fighting for survival now, this youngster, last year's European youth champion. Shows you the strength of Germany, having the European youth champion and the senior European champion in Cho Dang as well. A break there for Stumper. Serve just comes so quick at you, and that almost matched with a little bit of topspin. It kicked up at the racket of Stumper. Cho Sung-min.
Stumper knows he has to win this game, otherwise career go into the lead for the first time in this tie.
Can fall Stumper's technique when he's over the table, when he's given time and knows where the ball's coming. That's world class. But Cho Sung-min, especially as a left-hander with his style, is very suffocating to play against, and he knows exactly, obviously, how to play right-handers. Stumper can't drop the racket into the table on the backhand flick, so Cho Sung-min is playing these serves with a lot of backspin right now.
Is that the way to take him on?
I'd say so, and it's working well. Stumper wants to flick, he wants the open rally. He doesn't like slow spinning and then have to counter his opponent's counter.
Good power there from Stoffer. And that's got all his teammates on their feet. We had an interesting observation, didn't we? Our producer told us today that perhaps the Koreans were indulging in some mind games this morning by having a couple of their young players sit right next to the Germans at breakfast.
Yeah, the beautiful hotel breakfast hall is quite empty now, as most teams have gone home on their chartered flights. So when there's so much space left, you wonder why the young Koreans went to sit very close to the Germans. It'd be interesting to...
Yeah, the very team that you're playing against later on.
Four, five.
Bit of presence pressure, maybe.
No. Nothing wrong with a bit of gamesmanship.
Characterizes a lot of Koreans, their ability to come over the table against a ball that's doesn't even seem really long, more half long. I think them and the Chinese are the best at that.
This one is the closest game we have had so far. Remember, the one of these players has run away with it. He's annoyed himself, Stumper. In front here.
See a lot of German players now with aura rings to track their sleep patterns. Quite interesting. This wouldn't be a match, I believe, that Kai Stumper would lose much sleep over if he was expected to, in terms of how decorated he is compared to the player, how much experience Chosun Min has. There's definitely more pressure on the Korean to win this.
Okay. Let's see how this goes.
Not quite the level of Anjaikin away from the table, Chosun Min.
Stumper. Three away from leveling this. And forcing a fifth.
The shorter side, the parallel. It's a longer length to go across court from that position.
This is tight again. Stumper. He's almost there.
Great shot off the half long into that question zone, the crossover point. Table awareness of players to brush up the back of a half-long ball is one of the most impressive things. The ball sometimes even disappears beneath the playing surface.
Nine.
Struggle on that surf from time to time today, Coach Stumper. None of the previous games have been this close. Try a long shot. To moved things along by Schipper, and he's now got a game point here. Stumper. In the closest game we've had thus far in this third match. Excellent work from the youngster. Look at that reaction as well. I was going to give up asking Fraser on his predictions, but... Who do you think? Come on.
Well, I ask you this time, man. Pull it to lead. Who do you think?
I think Cho.
You think Cho? I would agree.
Oh.
I would agree.
We're swapping roles here.
Stumper isn't the player that you're going to see playing loop-to-loop rallies, making a lot of top tens in the top, you know, top 10 points of competitions.
Right.
But his serves set up his third balls very well. He flicks well. Probably want to improve his touch play a little bit. But we'll see. Someone serve quite like Stumper. The way he kind of revs up for it is quite.
It's quite unorthodox. Yeah.
It's quite abrupt.
One way that was going to hit.
There's the basics. Welsh Stumper doesn't have massive amounts. Shots to his game, right? Not so many strings to his bow, but the strings that he does have are well cemented. Good foundation.
Nothing like a good cemented string.
But it definitely makes the string stronger if they're surrounded by cement, right? So. See it in his forehand when he warms up, how long of a stroke it is on his forehand.
Good serve there from Stumper.
We're reverse pendulums causing a lot of issues for Cho Sung-min.
Able to assert himself on this game.
Practicing the high toss, is he gonna go for it? He is.
Hey!
They're both been good at serve, haven't they?
Very good. Who dares wins? Who wants it more?
All important question.
He survived. The step around was so big. Stumper just blocks it back just enough. Doesn't get over that one enough on the second ball. Cho Sung-min. And now Stumper has the serve. So wouldn't surprise me to see a reverse pendulum. Been sitting up like a child in a high chair, the receive. So let's see.
Let's see what we're having next. It's got to be disappointed with that.
That was such an opportunity. It's a break there for Cho Sung-min. Stump has been good with that third ball backhand. He'll be very disappointed if he can't win this.
Both of them have spurned these sort of chances.
So many fortunate breaks. And you know it's fortunate because usually they're putting these away.
Yeah.
Questioning the mentality now, aren't you?
I was just going to say, is it the occasion? Is that getting to them, perhaps?
1-all, 2-all in games in the fifth game, 7-all. This is nip and tuck. Very, very tense moment. Pressure's all in the mind, though.
Stumper just in front.
Time out.
Deine Aufschlägequalität nach oben, nach unten, nach unten. Nach unten.
Moment in this time. Kay Stumper. Kay Stumper is just in front of here.
That high toss backspin short serve has suffocated Stumper's flick. Yes. But he has the serves. He's been very good behind them. Like he's going for the reverse pendulum. Counter that he had to make. And he did.
Timeout.
Look how close these timeouts have come to each other.
Very, very close. This time the Germans asking for it.
Versuch nicht wie wild über die Vorhand anzugreifen. Versuchen da irgendwo einen Weg anzuspielen, den Ball dann. Okay? Ja, gut, guter Aufschlag machen dann, ja, gut bewegen dann. Wenn er dann Aufschlag macht, ja, und er macht den wieder kurz, ja, denn der war jetzt zweimal so viel Unterschied drin, okay, dann legst du ihn einfach ab. Er soll den Fehler machen, okay? Ja, du machst jetzt guten Aufschlag, ja, und dann bist du drin im Spiel, okay? Komm mal, Karl, komm mal.
Cho Sung-min just needs two more points. 2-1. He's got the confidence. Match points here. Two of them for Cho Sung-min.
So hungry for his team here when he eats up that serve.
Was that in the slot though? Was that there to be taken?
Absolutely. The serve didn't quite have the surprise factor, but still, surprisingly quick forehand.
Yeah! Oh, what a way to win it.
Oh.
For Cho Sung-min and Korea.
To put a match away of such tension with that element of swagger really puts a nice finish to this match, and you can see some laughs of both probably relief and jubilation there. Look at this. The Koreans are 2-1 up in the semi-final.
Real delight there for the Koreans. Cho Sung-min comes through, as I told you he would, Fraser. Brilliant play from the Korean.
Hey, I thought he'd win as well, Shazad. Don't.
You did.
Don't
you
do
did.
Me like that.
Fair enough. We both called it. Excellent win for Cho Sung-min. Well, Kai Stupa has certainly played his part in an excellent match. So Cho Sung-min beats Kai Stupa 11-6, 4-11, 11-5, 9-11, 11-8. He wins by 3-2. And we're now going to hear from the winner of that match. Here is Cho Sung-min.
Congratulations.
축하드립니다.
How does it feel to be in the semi-final?
첫 번째 질문입니다. 현재 준결승에 올라오셔서 소감이 어떻습니까?
처음으로 세계대회 단체전을 출전하게 되었는데 이제 엄청 긴장되고 주목받는 경기라고 생각했던 것 같습니다.
He said, "This is my first time to play on the, such the high level table tennis championships, and this is very good. This is a close match tie. What's the mood in the team?"
여태까지 독일 팀과 점수가 좀 팽팽해서 전체 팀 분위기가 어떻습니까?
1대1 상황에서 3번을 하게 되는 게 처음인데 그 엄청 긴장되고 좀 몸에 힘이 많이 들어갔는데 게임 하면서 동료들이 좀 다독여주고 감독님도 확실하게 믿음을 주셔가지고 경기하는데 도움이 많이 됐던 것 같습니다.
He said, "The score before is 1-1, and I played the third game. I am very nervous, but I heard encouragement from my teammates, and I'm very happy. Thank you."
Thank you.
감사합니다.
Well, nervous he was, but he certainly played his part in it. And now Korea, for the first time in his tie, are up in it. 2-1 the score, and that sets it up for the fourth match here. Jung Woo-jin of Team Korea is up against Cho Dung of Team Germany. You know I'm only going on, yeah. You could call me filthy, K-I-D, his eye, he don't mind you. 92, broken down, third eye, Yorji. Keep on, I just keep on, cause I'm current, boy, catchy. I'm a blow try, yeah. You and I, pick your nine. Hajima, Uri, no, Udala, we just different, I don't wanna. Georgia, now, Jimmy, now, Sitsa, now, but you don't know, but I'm on, I'm a blow try. You and I, pick your nine. Hajima, Uri, no, Udala, we just different, I don't wanna. Georgia, now, Jimmy, now, Sitsa, now, but you don't know. The practice hall here at the High Tech Sports Centre, the World Team Championships Finals. And we've got some fantastic ties still to come. China and Japan are in action with both men's and women's teams. So you know that the excitement is going to ratchet up here. Meanwhile, in this semi-final between Korea Republic and Germany, for the first time in this tie, the Koreans are up thanks to Cho Seung-min's victory over Kai Stumper in the third match. And that will set us up now for the fourth. And if Jung Woo-jin wins it, Korea Republic are through to the final.
게임 내용 과감하게 할 때 연결로 할 때 계산만 잘 해서 해.
어? So, Fraser, tell us your thoughts on how this one could pan out. The styles and the what we've seen from them so far, because you were a little bit disappointed with Jung Woo-jin earlier on.
Jung Woo-jin was definitely not up to scratch in the opener. But you've got to give credit to the dude, Benedict Duda, for the way that he played there. This is actually, in terms of world ranking, Cho Dang's match to lose, but...
Yeah. How did you feel Cho Dang played earlier?
Cho Dang, it's tough to say how much the injury affected him. He went to the side and definitely stretched out, and it feels as though he's okay now. Stylistically, Jung Woo-jin, I mean, we know he can run forehands for fun. So I think that he's a slight favourite in this match, Jung Woo-jin.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting, isn't it? Jung Woo-jin certainly played below par. Cho Dang lost a match that on paper he should have won. As you can see there, he's a top 10 player. And yeah, we talked about that little injury timeout he had. What a game after that. Anyway, seems to be okay.
They both have a point to prove, interestingly, which you wouldn't have thought that in terms of the lineups.
Coming into this, look, they have both been number nine. Cho Dang is the current world number nine, and Jung Woo-jin has hit those heights previously. So, you know how good they are. Let's shake hands against and hold again. Hit world number nine just over 3 years ago, Jung Woo-jin.
2018 triple champion at the Korea Open. He beat Liang Jingkun in the final in straight games. That was his kind of breakthrough. Beat Xu Xin en route as well to that final. He's beaten a good number of Chinese. Cho Dang is yet to prove that point, but in such a good position now, winning the contender Lima. Jung Woo-jin's won a couple of WTT titles this year as well.
He's also the world champion doubles silver medalist from Houston last year. But he knows he wins this match and they are through to the semis.
Charlie, come on!
That's the weapon right there. The serve set it up well, even if you push slightly slow, he will step around and play that shot with such ferociousness. Cho Dang's touch play and receive play is going to have to be very, very good to remove this from Jung Woo-jin.
Good start. It's a confident start for Jung Woo-jin.
Just lightning quick. It's tough sometimes to say who's got the best footwork in the Korean team, but I'd say Jung Woo-jin probably the quickest.
Knows he has to win his match to stay in this tie.
Did it against France, can he do it against Korea? Yeah.
1-2.
Three!
Two-all.
Great depth on the block. I think he apologised for a slight edge. Died off it a little bit, perhaps it was. Hit the paint on the back. Oh, then the edge.
It's all levelled out, right?
Straight away. Bit of a more unreturnable ball there for Cho Dang than what it was for Jung Woo-jin. Nice brushing flick up as the racket face just comes across it to this guy's where he's going with it. Slows the pace down. Jung Woo-jin wants to play quick.
Yeah.
He's amazing in the loop-to-loop games. Hunts the forehand. So slowing things down may be effective here against the Korean. I'm sure Ross Kopf knows the spot on way to beat Jang Woojin. Doing it is a different thing.
This is good stuff from Cho Dam, who now goes two ahead of Jang Woojin. Off that serve. Excellent from Jang Woojin.
I hate to be on the receiving end of that.
What did he do so well there?
It was surprising, it was deep, it was quick, and it had backspin on. That's had literally every single good mechanic of a long serve.
Yes! Two good service points there for Jang Woojin.
He bounces back well when he's a couple points down, Jang Woojin. I've noticed that.
Yes, come on!
In the blink of an eye, he has gone level. He was under a bit of pressure there, wasn't he, Jang Woojin?
Jang Woojin may find Cho Dang an easier matchup because not only is Cho Dang right-handed, but he's got the reverse pin on backhand, which is a little bit weaker. Although against backspin, Cho Dang's backhand is amazing down the line. Keep the ball very low, Cho Dang.
Wonderful from Cho Dang again. He was just had the pressure on him and he's relieved it here. A couple of good points.
A wrong footing flick. So Jang Woojin, you will barely ever see him play a long push or a touch with the backhand side. Stands so biased towards the backhand side that he'll usually touch with the forehand. And he'll flick with the backhand like we saw there.
So I've probably told you that Jang Woojin has a win percentage of 67. Excellent winner from Cho Dang.
Amazing timing there. Did well as well. Keep focused after Jang Woojin got that net against him.
He has a poor record against pen holders, Jang Woojin. I know he hasn't played many, but he's only won 5 out of 16 matches against pen holders, 31%.
Wow. Which he's actually low. Played quite a few.
Yeah, low. Low.
I know he had a losing record against Wang Chun-Ti. I'm guessing he has a losing record against Xu Xin, although he has beaten Xu Xin. And he's also beaten Wang Chun-Ti, of course. I'm just trying to think what other penalties he may have played there.
He got him right down, didn't he, Jang Woojin? He's playing so well here. Look at this.
This ball. This one here, this one that he played out the middle. Look at that.
Quick space for himself. Superb. 9-all.
You can't really teach those kind of shots, to be honest.
Until they happen.
Yeah.
Okay. he's got. Slender game point, Jung Woo Jin. Remember, there was a 4-point lead for Cho Dung. Excellent work from the German.
He's toying very well with the fact that Jung Woo Jin likes to step around to play the forehand from the backhand. So he's putting it down that half. And then as soon as he commits, Cho Dung plays the opposite side. It's going to be a fairly common theme, tactics-wise, from Cho Dung. It worked very well there at a crucial moment. You just know Jung Woo Jin's going to be looking for this third ball forehand, though.
Need it this time.
Short backspin.
Yeah, he's got his second game point here. And he's saved another one, Cho Dung.
There it is, the RPB down the line against the push. He's just so, so good at this. He did a float serve there, so Jung Woo Jin knew he couldn't hack under the ball. It would have gone long if he would have tried to play a push of a lot of quality. Clever serve from Cho Dung as well.
Got him!
Third game point for Jung Woo Jin. Game points, isn't
it? He nearly got Cho Dung twice there with the long push into the middle, but this time the German, look, makes the adaptation that he needs and plays it into the middle of Jung Woo Jin. The amount of split second decisions these guys have to make is just a joke.
Yeah, it's so, so fast, those decisions that have to be made.
It's like, oh, I'm in an uncomfortable position and now I have to make you more uncomfortable.
So for the first time, Cho Dung now has a game point. Pressure is on Jung Woo Jin. Cho Dung has turned it around. Three game points he saved. And he has taken the lead here.
Omo, 지금 그 수루만 자꾸만 하는데 회전 놓고도 기다렸다 뺐다도 걸어야 되고 어차피 너가 그거 해야 이겨. 그냥 수루만 열한 개 못다. 그 제도 범실도 놔야 되고 전공법으로 한 5, 6점을 따주고 수가 이어져 있다.
Well, number 9, Cho Dung, the European reigning champion. Dusting off a few things off the table there. Umpire will come and guarantee that there's nothing on the surface that there shouldn't be, and we will resume here with the second game. It's a must win for Germany. It's a must win for Cho Dung. Dong Woo-jin has definitely, definitely not been at his best in this tie.
Yeah, what's going on there? Because he looked a little nervy. He's been in some good positions.
Perhaps a few nerves. As the leading man for Korea, he understands what this means here in Chengdu at the World Team Championships. Korea haven't made a final since 2008.
Semi-finals in the last five. We can see the confidence at the moment as we show down.
Definitely, that was a beautiful backhand from Zhang Wujin though. Nice and arky. We're giving him the time there to try and make the forehand if Cho Dang would have made his. Snatched at it a little bit there, the German. Saw the Hollywood headlights and went for a nice finish.
Left. Three ball.
On the run here, Cho Dang. Oh, sorry, Jung Woo Jin, because you feel he needs a cushion at the moment against Cho Dang.
Quipped is the funniest man in the Korean team. He doesn't look to be in much of a mentality to make a joke right now, does he?
Need to dig deep here, Korea. And you know, prior to this tie, you were talking about the Korean mentality being probably right up there with the Chinese.
Yeah, definitely. They don't show much respect against their opponents. They just come out flying no matter who they're playing, and some players will think too much about who they're up against, not what they need to do. And the Koreans are very solid mentally.
Lovely, delightful from Cho Dang down the line.
Gorgeous redirection. I'm absolutely in love with this shot that he plays. Curves out wide as well. You say they need the cushion, Shazad, and it's evident that. Couldn't agree with you more.
So it's whittled down to just one, and we're going to have a timeout here.
Who's that on the table? What a daft question that is. Van Shendong and Ma Long, best two players we have seen definitely in the last 5 years of the sport. Ma Long, the greatest in terms of achievement we've ever seen. They are warming up for their semi-final tie, which will go against Japan. And I know a lot of you table tennis fans out there, as well as myself, licking your lips at the thought of seeing what Kazu Harimoto especially can do to challenge the Chinese.
Yeah, but they need probably a little bit more than that. But yeah, that's going to be fascinating to watch.
Wow.
Meanwhile, here, just not hitting his marks at the moment, is he?
The quality of the pushes from Cho Dang almost emphasized by the sound of the contact of the racket on the table. He's putting so much into the pushes with quality, because Jang Woojin will hit more forehand winners than I've had hot dinners if he's given the time.
Had a fair bit of cold food, I think.
Do like my sushi.
Cho Dang in front. Now, important. There's 2 points that he's got here, Cho Dang.
Look at the frustration.
He's not a happy bunny right now.
Better smashing the ball than the racket, but I mean, still.
How is he going to turn this around now? Jang Woojin. Cho Dang's on serve as well.
Struggling to be himself out here, Jang Woojin, isn't he?
Whoa! Ooh.
The control of this German Mercedes. So mechanical, so well engineered this point, the way he blocks it out wide, doesn't do anything more than he needs to, and then he's drives through that chop of Jang Woojin.
Well, he's converted that game point for the first time of asking Cho Dang. He's gone two up here, and Germany will feel a lot better about things at the moment. Jang Woojin in some trouble here. Cho Dang has won game two, 11-7.
그럼 우리가 내가 수세에 몰리는데 하나를 띄우고 그 다음에 들어가더니 띄워도 반경은 없어. 반경은
So, Fraser, you've just commented that he's not quite been himself today, Jang Woojin.
No, he's struggling to play his game, but the Germans know how to shut down his strength, which is his forehand, evidently, Jang Woojin. Playing into his strength, but then exposing it at the same time.
Got it!
Yeah, he's not looking happy.
It was a redemption match for both players, but of course Cho Dang had to battle for survival. And he's doing so excellently. He did it against Alexis Lebrun against France yesterday after losing to Felix in the first. So patterns are re-emerging here.
Look, he's had little moments like these, but they're few and far between for Jang Woojin. Showdown overall.
Four, two.
Alice Clark for Chodang right now, 4-2 in the lead. The way he extends through as well on the RPB is really, really good. John Mujin in more than a spot of bother now.
Sorry!
Yeah, he's such a good stick for now, isn't he?
I feel like John Mujin's weapons are more dangerous, but Chodang has more variation.
So Chodang in that sense has been the smarter player for you.
Absolutely.
5 points clear here. Desperately needed that, didn't he, John? It's quite muted at the moment for the Koreans.
Very, very useful points for Zhang Wujin.
Again, another thing about this match for Zhang Wujin is that he hasn't buried his serves a lot. The reverse pendulum is coming in now, but it's in such a bad position, score-wise for him.
This is a good little period for Zhang Wujin overall, isn't it?
Mm.
But it's more of that. It's a timeout as well called for Germany.
Timeout. Der Ball ist drin, ja, aber dass du den vielleicht noch wechseln, dann rutscht mal, ja, dass du dir ein bisschen verändert von der Platzierung her, dann, ja, und nicht automatisch den nächsten Mal immer lang, was dann immer kurz und lang schnell ist. Ja.
Fraser, you feel at the moment that perhaps Zhang Wujin is a bit stuck in his ways, is he?
A little bit stubborn. He's changing things, but a little bit too late. Chodang is changing something as soon as he feels as though he needs to change it. He's recognising it sooner than it needs to come. And look at this now.
Hey.
Zhang Wujin won 2 points straight off the reverse pendulum, which we haven't really seen yet.
All of a sudden,
8-4.
It is 8-4.
This would have serious scar power. Very tough to sweep this giant cobweb under the carpet, knowing he should have wrapped this up 3-0. And look at this.
Yeah. You think that's going to have an effect?
I think this could go to the fifth if Zhang Wujin wins this game, definitely. Because, I mean, imagine knowing you were, what, 2-0, 8-4 up, couldn't wrap it up.
Come on.
It was a huge cushion for Chodang.
Yeah, didn't take advantage. Well, it's been a remarkable little turnaround here for Zhang Wujin, who's now got a couple of game points. He looked like he was out of this.
Element of fear in the blocks of Chodang. It's a good job they're placed quite well because I can tell he's almost awaiting that pouncing, punishing forehand.
go down at drawn level. This is swung back and forth. And now, at deuce, we need a winner by two clear points.
Aye.
Point all of a sudden.
The biggest Cho Dang has Cho'd.
Well,
took a slow block to do it, but it was really, really clever.
This to make it two all in the tie. Move us to a fifth match. The drama doesn't end.
Well, well, well. What a match is made between these two. I kind of want to see it go even further.
Chang Woojin now has game point.
The punch that this little Korean man packs. Absolute pocket rocket. You get a lot of value for your money with Chang Woojin, don't you?
Left, 11 curl.
There is another chapter to this tale. Shahzad, what do you think?
Yeah, Chang Woojin converts. This is epic, isn't it? And we are going into another game here. Chang Woojin looked like he was out. He has come back here. He has taken that third game.
13
this fourth game now.
Got it! Four!
So I'm just wiping the floor around the table, just where he slipped earlier.
He's touching this serve very well now, Chang Woojin. That's another thing. He's not flicking. He's touching. And Cho Dang sending the ball long with the push, not retouching. Can't help myself, Shahzad, but just think towards that deciding match, which would be between An Jae-hyun and Duda.
You're already looking ahead to that, I think.
Hard not to, just in case it does go to that, but
And how do you think that one could pan out if it comes to it?
So tough to say stylistically.
Very different again, aren't they?
Yeah.
At the moment, okay, just going by the scores and overall how these players have looked, you would have to say fifth is very likely. On to lose.
He does so well to lob those back. Chodang's putting side spin on them, and look how the ball just kicks away.
Yeah. It moved away, didn't it, from Chodang?
Volley!
I think Zhang Wujin distracted himself there. The fact that his bat made contact with the table and the noise it made. For his third ball forehand. What a match.
Anyway, Zhang Wujin wins this, takes it to 2-0. You'd think the momentum is clearly with him. And you made a very good point in that second game, in that third game rather.
Running!
Chodang was 8-4 up. And went on to lose that game.
Goodness me, they're just trading blows.
Yeah, it really is like trading blows now.
Like a training drill.
It felt like it, didn't it? It sounded like it. And it is so tight now. Every point now being recorded by the Germans.
Just so disciplined, Chodang, isn't he? Stays close to the table, using all that Zhang Wujin power and redirecting it. Really distressed facially, Zhang Wujin. Usually there's a glimmer of humour in his eyes, but not now.
Sorry. Oh. These are things going Chodang's way. He's now got a lead of 4. He had that earlier as well, but he couldn't make it count in the previous game. What a time to be doing that.
5-10
for Zhang Wujin. 5 match points. Saves one.
10-6.
Now Chodang to serve for the match. And then push this game, or this tie rather, into a fifth. A fifth match. Really well done by Chodang. Excellent work. Zhang Wujin has lost both his matches today. Chodang has redeemed himself, as Fraser mentioned earlier. And Germany will be delighted with this.
Relieved, if anything, but now it's going to have to come down to this man again. Benedikt Duda in the decider. Can he beat An Jae-hyun?
the man with the most feeling in this Korean side.
So Cho Dong has beaten Jung Woo-jin 14-12, 11-7, 11-13, 11-6. He's won by 3 games to 1. And that means we are moving into a fifth match shortly. We're going to hear now from Cho Dong, the winner of that match against Jung Woo-jin.
Congratulations. How does it feel to have brought the team back into the tie with this win?
Yeah, obviously, it's an amazing feeling for me. I mean, Bennett brought us in the first match. He won the first match. We got a small break, and I wanted to win the second match as well. I couldn't do it. Then we were trailing back 1-2. Now I'm just happy that we could equalize, and Bennett has the chance to finish the match.
What words do you have for Duda before the decider?
I mean, I don't need to say much. Yesterday, he also played the decider against France, and he won this match, so I'm fully confident for him that he will bring it back.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Well, that's a very good point. Benedict Duda did it against the French. He can do it again. Cho Dong has plenty of confidence in him. We are going to a fifth and deciding match here in the men's team semifinals. It's An Jae-hyun of Team Korea versus Team Germany's Benedict Duda. Is Chengdu, the site of the 2022 World Team Championships Finals. It has been an exhilarating 8 or 9 days or so in the high-tech zone sports center where all the action is taking place. We are down to the last few teams left in this competition. In the men's team semi-finals, Korea Republic are playing Germany, and we are going into our fifth and final match. It has been a tight affair, and the Germans have shown resolve here to come back into this.
So now it's down to An Jae-hyun and Benedict Duda. He earned a bronze for himself in Budapest. Can he earn at least a silver for his team here in Chengdu?
This is a man with a rather languid style, An Jae-hyun. Unpredictable player, as Rosa said. He's perhaps a real version of Jules Morgard. Benedict Duda, seems a long, long time ago when he last played. This match was 3 hours ago.
Wow. This has been an absolute war, a marathon between these two teams. And almost impossible still to say who will be going through to face the winner of China and Japan.
Listen, when you have such a war of attrition here, this probably works into China's hands, isn't it? Plays into their hands. They're going to be mentally exhausted after this. Germany have had two of these kind of ties, haven't they?
It's not been easy for the Germans. If they get through this without their 3 Olympic silver medalists.
I mean, that's an achievement in itself, isn't it?
Wow.
An Jae-hyun, 22 years of age, 47th in the world. He
saw him earlier. He was absolutely superb, wasn't he? An Jae-hyun in his win against Cho Dang. Played some breathtaking table tennis. Benedict Duda, much more functional player.
Yeah.
But he did the business against Jung Woo-jin earlier.
He did, one of his best career wins, probably his second best career win. Down to him again. I mean, An Jae-hyun, a lot of people were questioning why you said you could have chosen him for this tie. If he wins two against Germany here, you'd see why, because a lot were wondering why Cho Dae-sung wasn't playing. Little enlarge battle between these two right now, an absolute contrast in physique. But look at the head-to-head.
Yeah, it's both in An Jae-hyun's favour. That levels things up. Benedict Duda has reached highest ranking of 30th in the world, 35th for An Jae-hyun.
I like how the stat says dominant hands, as though to say, well, yeah, these players are quite
actually
capable of playing.
Yeah.
First game, Korea to Seoul, level.
Koreans on their feet. It's been a while since we've seen that from them. Just to let you know, the two times that these players have met. In Japan Open in 2019, An Jae-hyun won that 4-1. And at the WTT Star Contender in Doha, Qatar last year, where An Jae-hyun won that 3-1.
Nice counter there from Duda. Wow. Top draw player there from the German.
Well, he's much more vocal now than he was earlier.
It's huge for him. 22 years old. He hasn't won a tournament or been close to winning one since 2019 at the World, his breakthrough where he came through as a qualifier.
Ole!
It's almost like An Jae-hyun knows, yeah, I won't be remembered by how many WTTs I mean, I'll be remembered by what I do in the World Champs. Although people do remember, of course, how many Pro Tours you win and such. My long the leading ever player with Vladimir Samsonov. At two.
Net.
In terms of all-time Pro Tour wins.
Makes no mistake there, putting that away.
Still had quite a lot to do there, An Jae-hyun. Very spinny ball. Manages to come in, recognize it. It's not over until it's over. Kind of guy, isn't he, An Jae-hyun? He's like the kid at school that doesn't revise for his exams but still gets straight A stars.
Because he's just got that ability, isn't he? Natural ability.
Goal!
I feel like Duda's going to have more variation to deal with than An Jae-hyun. What's the point you were saying, Shazad, about Benedict Duda being more of a straight-up sort of attacking. You know what you're getting with him a little bit more than you do with An Jae-hyun.
So that's a bit predictable, right?
A little bit, but he's the bigger of the two guys, right?
No!
Not the kind of guy you want to be lobbing off.
Yeah.
I added some side spin to that. That was a nice faded smash there from the dude. Wow, look at the intensity. Even the uninvolved coaches in this tie here so emotionally invested in what this means for Team Korea.
Nicely done.
Playing a few floating touches into the middle, so he wants Duda to then push along with not too much quality. Good tactic.
Nothing in this.
This is the kind of moment here that can treasure a player as a national hero.
Yep, really good. Tactic, isn't it, Ahn Jae-hyun?
So deep on the table, those forehands, and a lot of transfer through the waist. Fabulous arc on the ball there with that forehand, and they rise the Korean bench.
Now, a 2-point cushion that Ahn Jae-hyun has. This is going back and forth, this one.
Very good player in the rally. I saw some beautiful points between himself and Trang Chi-wan in one of the feeders this season in the States. Trang Chi-wan still taking titles in his 40s.
Yeah, saw him training the other day. It was really intense, wasn't he?
Oh, an excellent touch from Duda, and then plays the topspin into the middle. Big there as well, because now at least, even if Ahn Jae-hyun wins his points, he'll have to serve level. Seems like a must-win point here for Ahn Jae-hyun.
Ah, did he put that away? Excellent cross-court from Ahn Jae-hyun.
A wide serve and then the forehand on the step around, even wider.
Incredible. Played that beautifully. Getting that table white. This is tight, this one again. In keeping with this tie overall.
Oh,
Duda with that stormy rally. That first game, it was a tight one. He comes out on top. Germany with the edge now in this tie.
So,
Benedikt Duda takes game one, 11-9 in this fifth match.
Dass er nicht zu nah steht am Ball, sonst hat er den Rückhalt. Wenn er kurz spielt, kurz zurückspielt, wenn er den Aufschlag seitlich ausmacht, gar nicht dran denkt.
Stuff. Sort of has a bit of fun with it.
Yeah.
In a sort of a do or die situation like this now, do you think they'd probably want him to be a bit more orthodox?
In a do or die against Duda, it feels less appropriate, right?
Yeah.
But I mean,
that's his game though. You can't to change that all of a sudden would be very difficult and a risk.
It's funny because he didn't do it a lot at the World Championships in his breakthrough tournament in 2019. He seems to have done it since he's achieved that. This is huge. This is massive. This is for a team final spot at the World Table Tennis Championships. Germany looking to repeat history. Korea looking to achieve it for the first time in a long while. Just thinking that. Seriously, I think Korea. Yeah.
They would rather face.
No,
Korea.
Sorry. I think they'd rather face Germany. I think Korea would do a better job. But the strongest team out here, Team Korea. Germany don't, and that makes it even more impressive that they're even here like this. Tactics-wise, the Germans can find better ways, but style-wise, I see Korea doing a better job.
And for the first time in this game, Anjay Kim goes in front.
For example, I couldn't see Duda beating any of the three Chinese, but I could see maybe Zhang Wujin winning one if he's playing out of his skin.
I'm sure there was no chance of his opponent getting to that one.
Spotting the gaps very well, the German. And Jaehyun may not want to enter these rallies as he is doing.
Big roll again from Anjahyun.
He's a big game player. He's not as good as Duda on the WTT circuit. But he's achieved more than the German on a world stage before.
Four set!
Important points here for Anjahyun.
I feel like Anjahyun's more of a natural player than Duda. I feel like Duda's just been drilled to death. But there is a fluidity that he's developed a lot more of.
It'd
be interesting actually to watch Duda as a junior to see how he played.
Six all in the second game. Could go either way. Han Jae-hyun knows he can ill afford to go two down here.
Got it!
Fortune doesn't work out in his favour.
That was a chance, wasn't it? One of the better rallies we've had in this match.
Against Jang Woo Jin as well.
He moves three clear now of An Jae-hyun, two away from making this 2-0. Good position here for Benedict Duda. Can he see it through? Game points.
I didn't think looking at this tie that it would be Benedict Duda that would be the standout star man. But look at what he's doing.
He has converted it. Benedict Duda is two up here. But Germany are just one game away from a place in the final.
Das war gut gewesen. Ja. Der Anfall ist gut. Ja. Einfach das, was du spielst, komplett runterziehen. Dann hat man, ja. Wenn du abhaken kannst, ist gut. Wenn du nicht spielst, irgendwo, ich finde die Rückhand halt lang. Ja. Und das war bis zum Schluss ein tiefe Vorhand spielen. Dann bleibt er mehr stehen. Ja.
Hi.
Han Jae-hyun just seems a little understated here. He was pulling out all the champagne stuff, wasn't he, in the earlier match. He's got to dig deep here.
Volley!
But Duda is on a roll at the moment.
Fire and inspired Benedict Duda. He's possessed by ambition to win for his team. He'll be a man very well referenced and remembered for Germany, and he's a player that's come up so recently. You don't think of him as a big name, but this is going to really make him up there on the list.
That's more like it from Andrzej Good.
That's the champagne stuff again, Chazad. Fizzing forehands. Corker.
Haven't seen that in a while from it.
That's the kind of risk that he needs to give.
Yeah. Couple of very good points there for Andrzej Hjud. Korean. He's got a 3-point lead here now.
Seems like a specially testing moment mentally now for Duda. Let's not forget that he lost from 2-0 up against Satyan in the group stage against India, and he lost from 2-0 up against Alexei Lebrun in the quarterfinals.
This is what you were referring to earlier about perhaps that winning mentality of his.
This would be the most painful of the bunch, but he obviously can't afford to think like that.
Yeah, he's got to put that behind him, hasn't he? That's all done and dusted. And he's 3 points behind. He's 8 away from a superb result here against Korea.
He wasn't in the Halmstad team. Not playing anyway. That defeated Korea in 2018 in the semi-finals.
Much, much better from Andrzej Hjud.
Tying Duda up in the touch play. Not sending it long because he knows that Duda in the rally's actually been better than him.
He needed that, didn't he? Benedict Duda.
Quite swift, Duda, for a big guy. Another big German left-hander there, Fang Bomong, on the bench. Here is the reserve player.
Oh.
goodness me. If he makes that forehand.
Yeah, that would have been something. He doesn't know. And Duda is now within two of his opponent. And six away from wrapping this up. Look at that. How late did he take it? Wasn't far away at all.
Seatbelt shot attempt across the body.
What a winner! Played that superbly.
Come on. The angles that he's making here, Duda. Stunning. No one can argue with the class of that shot.
Die Idee dann auch mal den langen Schussball zu spielen, dann wenn es ein schwieriger Ball ist, ist genau richtig.
So Benedict Duda takes. Well, Ajay Hu takes that. Time back for now. So, Han Jae-hyun has a slender one-point lead. Benedict Duda wins this game. The tie is done, and Germany are through to the finals.
Jamming him up in a touch play. We established Duda sometimes thinks about the finish line a little bit too soon. What this means for both of these teams is the stuff of dreams.
You're a poet. You didn't even know it.
Oh, I did. Okay.
He's somehow getting it back.
You're kidding me. You are kidding me.
Again. Not all that far away. But his own teammates stand up to applaud that, Han Jae-hyun. That's what he can do.
If you wanted to have the best exhibition of all time, you'd hire Han Jae-hyun and Truls Morrigard.
Totally agree with you.
But it just doesn't seem appropriate to say.
I'm just wondering why this is happening now. Incredible, when his team is trailing here in these semi-finals. He needs that pressure again.
This is the tricky thing as a right-hander playing against the left. You play cross court, the longer length, you into their forehand. So you've got to be good on the parallels against someone of a different dominant hand. And that was nice there. He had a little bit more topspin, slowed it down, and Duda was tense on the backhand there. Missed it. Oh my goodness.
9-7.
Got game points here. An Jae-hyun. Duda pulls one back. Remember, he needs basically 4 points now to win this match and the tie. And Jae-hyun just taking his time. Still two game points to save for Benedict Duda. So well done, An Jae-hyun, who pulls one back. And we are going to go into a fourth. So An Jae-hyun takes game three, 11-8. But Duda is 2-1 up, though, in this fifth match. So we are now moving into the fourth game here. Epic tie, isn't it? Between Team Korea and Team Germany. Well, you mentioned about Benedict Duda earlier, and maybe some of the doubts have started to creep into his mind.
It would be the most painful of the bunch. Goodness me.
No! These are the kind of rallies that we've come to get used to when we watch An Jae-hyun.
He's hooking side-spinning forehands. Just don't want it to end. I know you should have before this match. You couldn't wait to see how this one finished.
Yeah. Put an end to this all, but I know the purists will just want this to go on and on. It's been some top quality stuff from both sides.
You almost feel as though An Jae-hyun can just draw out this, take a little bit longer. It will make Benedict Duda as a player in front a little bit impatient. Goodness me, if this goes to a fifth, if this team tie goes down to a single game, someone might have to come and take my place in the commentary booth because I won't be able to watch.
You should be so lucky. I think An wants to actually draw these out.
Yeah, he does. You can feel a few nerves in the racket of Duda. Bit of tension. And he's playing with slower spin now, giving Benedict Duda time to overthink the countertop spins. It's working well.
Yeah, I think we are kind of reaching a point now where every point going to be celebrated vigorously.
Stumbling backwards as he hit that. Look at that. Eyes of a tiger. Small stature of An Jae-hyun, more of an ocelot, though. Battle of little and large here. They couldn't be more contrasting, yeah, in terms of physiques.
You're right. Absolutely right.
Unpredictable where he was going to go with it, and it surprised An Jae-hyun into a chop block attempt. Miscontacted it, the Korean. In terms of implication, this is even bigger of a match than his quarter or semi-final in 2019 in Budapest.
Nicely put away.
When you think Korea table tennis, you think that shot there. The forehand. Step around, just electric footwork. It's all just a blur of blue right now. Will that have any scar power, as Adam Barbour likes to call it?
Volley!
This time he doesn't win. From that far back.
He treats the court like his playground, An Jae-hyun, doesn't he? But again, playing a forehand of that intensity and then dropping back the next point, you question the intensity and the concentration sometimes.
So Benedict Duda is 2 points up. He's five away, potentially, from wrapping this up. Important point for him. Important with an element of luck, perhaps. He doesn't care about that right now.
The bounce there, An Jae-hyun fired up with the forehand, withstanding the pressure of Duda and the change of placement into the middle. Goodness me. World number 36 with the serves.
Teasing, wasn't it? But it's three ahead and three required. That is the magic number now. important times here for Benedict Duda. He is almost there.
Just waiting for a long enough ball to attack, and it comes just long enough for Duda to brush up the back of it, painting the table wonderfully this game. Two away.
He's almost there.
Net. Five line.
And we have match points and tie points for Benedict Duda and Team Germany. He's on the brink of something quite special here, Benedict Duda. Yes, to put the celebrations on ice just for now. What a rally to finish it off! But Germany have won this! Zippity-doo-dah! What a wonderful day for Benedict! It has been absolutely brilliant! And look at those celebrations! Germany into yet another World Team Championships final for men.
Benedict Duda, the man who wasn't even part of the team when Germany got through to the final in Hamstad, has been instrumental in their run here in Chengdu for the second time in a row. He did it against France and Felix Lebrun, and he's done it here against An Jae-hyun. Germany are through to the final.
Well, there was so much drama in this. Absolutely everything left out there. This went all the way. Germany looked like they were in serious trouble. Duda had that two-game lead. An Jae-hyun has certainly played his part today because he served up some magnificent table tennis. So entertaining.
Couldn't get any better in terms of entertainment value. It was an absolute marathon. But he ran away with it in the end, Benedict Duda. And I'll tell you what, a worthy team to face the winner of China and Japan in the final. I know that Dmitry Ovcharov, Timo Boll and Patrick Franziska will be buzzing with the fact that these men here, these three men who filled their boots, have done so admirably.
Well, a fantastic performance from Benedict Duda. He has beaten An Jae-hyun 11-9, 11-6, 8-11, 11-6 by 3-1. Here is Benedict Duda.
Congratulations from defeat to India and now this high. How does it feel to help the team win that epic tie?
Yes, I'm just speechless and super, super happy. I don't know what to say, but yeah, the team did great today. We were fighting like crazy. South Korea is a very strong team, and yeah, I'm just happy that I won this fifth match.
You are now in the final. What are your thoughts?
Yes, it's the final. We will prepare again very well, and we will wait for our opponent, and we will give a big fight and hope that we perform very well tomorrow.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, after such an exhausting, draining affair there, they've got to think about the final tomorrow against China. But for now, let them savor what has been an absolutely superb performance. Duda started things off with that win over Zhang Wujin, and then An Jae-hyun stormed back against Chu Dung. Cho Seung-min had a tough, tough time against Kai Stumper, but won that one. And then Cho Dung he redeemed himself by beating Jung Woojin. Then we saw that epic fifth match. So Germany have become the first team to get themselves into the men's final here, and we will now await the result of that next semi-final. But what a way to get the day started. So talking of that other men's semi-final, there is Ma Long just getting those final bits ready, and Fan Zhenggong against Team Japan. Team China are up next in that next epic encounter. Japanese also getting themselves ready, as you can see. In just a few minutes from now, it is back-to-back literally here at the Chengdu High-Tech Sports Center. And then at 7:30, it's China versus Japan again. That's going to be the women's team's final. So much great table tennis coming up.